The Constellation Secret of Plotter is curious about your scam. The Constellation has sponsored you 200 coins.
The winner of the Rock, Paper, Scissors was decided in an instant.
Lee Gilliam's face was slightly flushed while Jonghyuk had a satisfied expression. Lee Jia flopped to the ground, devastated.
This is ridiculous!
Unfortunately, I couldn't read Lee Gilliam's mind, so two ampules went to him.
You don't have to give it to me.
Take it. He was cute. I stroked Lee Gilliam's head. In addition, Jonghyuk won two physique enhancement ampules. Jonghyuk received them with a smile.
Thank you. It was tough so far with my physique.
It was only Lee Jihad who didn't obtain any ampules.
Did you cheat?
I'm originally good at rock, paper, scissors.
Are you really going to do this? Can't you just give me one?
You have Yoo Jonghyuk. I ignored Lee Jihad's whines and packed the ampules. Jonghyuk patted the shoulder of the grouchy Lee Jihad while staring at her sword.
Little sister, the world has to be fair.
There was the sound of the helicopter's propellers. Lee Gilliam looked at the distant dinosaur island and asked,
Young, can't I take it to the next floor?
The big praying mantis was sitting on Lee Gilliam's lap and talking to Lee Gilliam. The praying mantis rubbed its antenna against Lee Gilliam's jaw. Unfortunately, you can't take it. Lee Gilliam hugged the praying mantis with a sad expression.
Take care, Titano.
He'd already given it a name. Unfortunately, monsters created in Theater Dungeon couldn't move to another floor. However, items could be taken to other floors. For example, I had the ampules that increased stats and the item I was now holding. Tyrant T-Rex's DNA ampule. The golden ampule was the most decisive reason for choosing this movie. It was an item that increased all stats by 10 for 30 minutes after ingestion. Although it had the disadvantage that it could only be used in the theater dungeon, it was impossible to break through the last floor without this item. Especially if Yoo Jonghyuk was in the worst situation as I thought. The praying mantis that Lee Gilliam released flew in the air and the dark sky started to collapse. The first ending credit has been reached. Performers, Kim Dokja, Jonghyuk, Lee Jihe, Lee Gilliam. You have obtained 500 coins as compensation. I felt some dizziness and we appeared on the ground floor again. After we escaped, the movie posted on the wall was torn. It was evidence that we safely cleared it. Lee Jihe was complaining.
Do we have to pass a few more floors like this?
Yoo Jonghyuk will have broken most of it, so it'll be faster than you think. We headed straight to the second floor via the escalator. From the second floor, the remaining space was narrow because it was a full-fledged theater. Jonghyuk asked,
There's no change?
No matter how long we waited, the environment of the second floor didn't change. The camera wasn't seen and the screening didn't start either. Looking closer, all the posters on the second floor were torn. Lee Jia noticed something.
Is it only movies whose posters are intact?
I checked the torn posters one by one. Pacific Rim directed by Guillermo del Toro. A giant robot fighting movie? Too bad. If this had been intact, then I could have gotten the reward of hardened gloves. Inception directed by Christopher Nolan. It was good that this one was torn.
Wow, I wanted to watch this.
I saw the poster that Lee Jia was looking at. Do you like superheroes?
Yes.
It's fortunate, otherwise you'd hate it after this.
I see.
On the torn poster, a green monster was roaring at us. We went straight to the third floor.
It's the same here.
All the posters on the third floor were torn as well. Yoo Jonghyuk had properly swept through it. It was fortunate since there were a lot of dangerous movies on the third floor. Final Destination directed by James Wan. That bastard Yoo Jonghyuk. How did he break this? This is an annihilation movie.
We're going up faster than I expected.
Unlike Jonghyuk's bright voice, I was nervous every time we climbed a floor. Clearing the theater dungeon required some luck. Some of the posters on each floor weren't covered in ways of survival. Yoo Jonghyuk didn't clear all movies. There was a system message when we reached the fourth floor. You have entered the fourth floor. The spotlight poured down without giving me time to look at the posters. Jonghyuk gathered both hands together and prayed.
Please don't be a ghost movie.
I glanced at Jonghyuk and she gave me an excuse.
Ghosts can't be killed with a sword.
This was the reason. The screening has started. The background changed, and when we opened our eyes, a sea breeze blew on the prow of a ship. This salt was felt in my mouth, and the open horizon spread out before me. I was enraptured by the scenery of the sea. I had been working every day, and it was been a few years since I traveled anywhere.
What is this movie?
Next to me, Jonghyuk was wearing a full-length dress. A violin sound was heard from the inside of the cruise ship, and there was the sound of excited people. It was an incredibly romantic atmosphere from a movie. Ah. I knew what movie this is. Then Lee Jia's voice was heard.
Accelerating all of a sudden.
I looked back and saw Lee Jia was vomiting. Jonghyuk rushed over and patted her back. After vomiting for a long time, Lee Jia said,
I get seasick.
It's okay, just vomit. I'd wondered this since a while ago. Why did the Duke of Loyalty and Warfare choose Lee Jia? No, I read the novel, I just didn't want to know.
But, Lee, is this the movie? The boat that sinks?
It seems so.
Then perhaps Unni is Kate Winslet?
Lee Jia was looking at Jonghyun's dress like she was envious. Then she looked at me.
Then Ajishi is DiCaprio?
I felt somehow grumpy when I saw her vomiting after saying that. At this time, Lee Gillian emerged from behind me.
Hyung!
Lee Gillian was dressed in formal clothing. This clothing was somewhat familiar. Anyway, everyone was gathered. There's no time. The ship was now sinking. Unfortunately, the solution to this movie didn't appear in ways of survival. How could we beat the Titanic? Was it a fight with the sea? Lee Jae was the first to comment. The ship is sinking anyway. Do we just have to sink with it? That's a little... It was frustrating. It would have been better if the movie had a clear enemy to crush.
Let's look for the villain, Hyung.
This was Lee Gillian's opinion. I didn't know if there was an obvious villain in this movie, but I couldn't think of anything else, so I decided to follow it. Then let's handle the villain. We started moving. By the way, who was this movie's villain? The last time I watched Titanic. But I didn't need to worry. The villain came to find us. A man in a clean suit was staring over here.
Jack Dawson!
Wait, Jack Dawson? The role that DiCaprio played? But the man wasn't looking at me.
Me?
He was DiCaprio? I sighed as I looked at Lee Gillian. After a while, we kidnapped a person we thought was the villain of the movie, but the theater master didn't respond. It wasn't enough to kidnap him. I hesitated for a moment before opening my mouth. Then, let's kill him. Lee Jae pulled out her sword and pointed it. It was at a man struggling while his body was tied up. The theater master is a psychopath, then isn't the answer to kill him quickly? I thought so as well. No, I was sure of it. It was the answer to another movie like this in ways of survival, but Jonghyun gazed at the man in horror and unexpectedly said,
But he looks like a real person.
Huh?
This is a movie, but he looks like a real person.
It was surprising that Jonghyun said this when she'd been neatly subjugated in the week a few days ago. Then again, Jonghyun had said something like this. I might be a killer, but I don't want to become a monster. Lee Jae asked,
Honey, what are you saying this type of sentimental thing now? You don't want to kill him?
No, that isn't... It's good to save people, but if this person doesn't die, we will die. We're definitely alive, but this guy's just a character.
Characters. I felt bemused at Lee Jia's words. Jonghyun looked at me.
Do you think so?
Even if this guy is a real person, he's still a bad guy. Why is killing him bad?
Lee Jia's words might be right. This guy was definitely the villain of the scenario and would do bad things, so it was okay to kill him. Funnily enough, it was the logic that Yoo Jonghyuk often spoke about in ways of survival. The moment I opened my mouth, Lee Jae hurriedly drew her sword.
What is this? Master could be dying right now!
The blade descended and pierced the man's chest. Blood poured out. It was incredibly realistic. Then a system message was heard. The theater owner is satisfied with the changed ending of the movie. The stern of the ship will lead to the next floor.
Look, I did it properly, right?
Lee Jae shouted triumphantly. The answer obviously wasn't wrong. The theater master acknowledged this, and the constellation would give coins for our actions. We would survive with these coins. It was a way of living to destroy this world. The second ending credit has been reached. Performers, Kim Dokja, Jonghyun, Lee Jae, Lee Gillian. You've obtained 500 coins as compensation. We weren't able to get a reward item from Titanic. Thus we went straight to the next floor and followed the guidance of the system message. You have entered the fifth floor, the rewards room. Once we climbed the escalator, the rewards room finally showed.
Rewards room? Isn't it a scary movie?
This is an exhibition hall. It was a place they used to show original movie props. In fact, I knew this, but I once again acted ignorant. Various movie props appeared in glass tubes. Equipment and costumes used by the main characters of various movies. Stage accessories. The funny thing was that they were no longer props. Jonghyun approached a glass tube and shouted,
Oh my god, look at this!
Mikazuki Munechika replica. A-grade sword. Jonghyun's eyes sparkled as she looked at the glass tube and I nodded. You finally obtained a proper sword, Hyun-shu.
Oh.
It was obviously a great sword at first glance. The Grohorn knife wasn't comparable, and it wasn't lacking when compared to Lee Jae's blade. Jonghyun started to swing the sword in her hand.
Isn't this amazing? It's light and moves properly.
I've never seen Jonghyun act like this. The character Jonghyun is deeply grateful to you. It was nothing. The main purpose of targeting the theater dungeon was the compensation of the fifth floor. The theater dungeon was a good place to farm items for early on. In particular, Jonghyun would become stronger with this weapon. The reward items are limited to 2 per person. It wasn't a genuine star relic, it was just a movie prop. But the replica version had characteristics of the original item. A-grade items were close to a scam in the early stages. By the way, Yoo Jonghyuk had already passed through here. 2 items were already gone. Pick your items. You can only take 2, so choose carefully. I told Jonghyun to pick up an item that Yoo Sang-ha could use while I found one for Lee Hyung-sung. This one seemed usable. Hercules Shield, replica, A-grade shield. Good. It was an item that couldn't be compared with the old Iron Shield.
I thought of how Lee Hyung-sung's eyes would shine with loyalty toward me, and I already felt warm. Lee Ji-hyo, who claimed to be a fan of superheroes, was trying to pull an item from the corner.
Why can't I hold this?
I came closer. This was it. Mjolnir, replica, A-grade blunt weapon. The hammer of the god of lightning, Thor. It would have been an enormous item if it was a genuine star relic. Still, the quality of the original was so great that the performance of the replica was significant. I watched Lee Ji-hyo groaning as she'd grabbed the hammer that couldn't be moved. Isn't this an item that only someone special can use?
Damn, I'm not special?
At this time, Lee Gillian came up behind her and reached out to Mjolnir.
Hey kid, this is mine.
Mjolnir was lightly lifted by Lee Gillian's hands. Lee Gillian swung the hammer around before looking at me.
Young, can I have it?
Yes, it looks good.
Lee Ji-hyo once again looked stunned.
Only I am unhappy. Just me.
I ignored her and searched the remaining items. Let's see what's left. External reinforced suit, replica. A-grade protective clothing. I didn't know what would happen in the future, but it would be nice to supplement my defense. Once I wore the suit, it wrapped around my arms and legs. Damage from external attacks is reduced by 10%. The ability to detect enemies is improved. You can move more agilely than before. It was a bit frustrating, but it was still better than not wearing it. In particular, I thought about the fight waiting at the end of this. Now the preparations were finished. Since there were no significant changes in the dungeon, it was clear that Yoo Jonghyuk was still alive. If we move quickly through the 6th floor, we might be able to meet on the 7th floor. In the worst case scenario, if he was fighting the boss on the 8th floor, at least he was still alive. Now let's go get our damn regressor back.